There are three key concepts that separate modeling in Grasshopper from modeling with Rhino. The first is that geometry creation and editing command are contained inside nodes called components. The second is that models are created by chaining the components that make up the modeling logic. The third is the ability to create model variations by turning input into parameters. Once you are familiar with these three concepts, you can start to parse Grasshopper models and create new ones. The first step to create any model is to figure out the steps or chain of commands to construct the model. In this case, we are creating a loft surface for a base. The loft surface goes through circles. The circles are created around points. The points are located along a line anchored at some location. You can turn any input into a parameter to create your model variations. As you get more familiar with the Grasshopper, you'll learn about the different components available and the different ways to set up input, how to pass geometry between Rhino and Grasshopper, and how to manage data. You can also take advantage of the many plugins that extend Grasshopper to support specialized functions.